And now our first speaker of the day, I'll get out of the way, is Lori Schechner. She's the director of medical imaging at Provena St. Joseph Hospital in Elgin, Illinois, which is a community hospital in the Chicago suburb. Lori holds a BS in business management from National Lewis University and an MBA from Keller Graduate School of Management from Chicago, Illinois. She is currently finishing her dissertation in order to complete a PhD in applied management decision science from Walden University School of Management. She is a fellow of the American College of Healthcare Executives. Lori is a dynamic, creative healthcare professional with an extensive background in the healthcare business. She has strong management and leadership skills with significant strengths in finance, marketing, strategic planning, and interpersonal skills. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Lori Schechner.
Thank you. Well, good morning, everyone. Hello, my fellow imaging friends and peers. I hope we're going to have a great day here today in this lovely city. Everyone's so quiet and serious because it's in the morning. We're morning people, aren't we? Well, my topic, as you saw, is leading operational changes within your medical imaging department. We have some challenging times ahead of us with change in our organization, and that's pretty much the catalyst what we're talking about this morning, how we apply it. Why is change so important? Well, first of all, change has a considerable psychological impact on our human mind. People have different feelings towards change and with change. And our job as a leader is to help transition and make change more acceptable. To some people, they're very afraid of change. It's considered very threatening because it means that things may get worse. They fear the worst. To others, it's very hopeful. They like change. It is encouraging to them because they think things might get better. And to the very confident kind of person, they think change is inspiring because the challenge exists to make things better. I always try to think about in imaging, have you ever tried to have change happen with radiologists in your department? Isn't that enjoyable? A lot of times they're like this, aren't they? And they're not very often in the hopeful things will get better, correct? Have any of you ever implemented voice recognition with the RADs? Yeah, that's a fun one. Remember this when you're trying to do that. I'm still struggling with that after a year. Change, why is it so important? Well, change is here to stay. We all know this. It's a constant with the demands we have from our marketplace, and we have to deliver more with less. We have to have change in order to accomplish our success. We have so many external forces right now with healthcare reform, reimbursement and whatnot, and I think as leaders, change, how we deal and manage change will really help us become more successful as imaging leaders. One's ability to lead change is becoming a key factor in determining one's job success. It's a known fact that how one manages change and or how they deal with being flexible and agile is a strong correlation with how successful you will be as a leader. Today we're going to talk about how to lead change with 5 steps. We're also going to talk about how people respond to change both negatively and positively. And we'll talk about the 2 important change variables, and that's adaptability with change and resilience, and also how to adapt when performing a reduction in force in medical imaging. Could I just ask how many of you have had to do this task yet as a leader? Hands up high. High and proud. You've done something very difficult. Okay, about a third or half of you. Okay. I'm going to share change. Do you think it's important in our culture? Oh, I think so. I mean, it was a one word, you know, very important thing all around us for our president right now. Change is everywhere. Why change requires us to involve other people? I think it's very important that we have participation that builds commitment when we're going to implement or plan for a change. Okay, and as leaders, we're the band leaders for this. We have to get everyone involved because then we'll get ownership and we'll have more success with that transition or change we're going to do. Change leaders must be masters at involving others for the momentum and the energy to build so that they can better accept and embrace change. I always say you have to turn on your sales and marketing skills when you're ready to plan a change. How many of you feel like you've had to do that as leaders, where you just got to just get it there, get it going, and how am I going to sell this, right? And when you sell something, you always have to think, what's in it for them, right? Whether it's the radiologist or the technologist, or even like if you're working with ER, what's in it for them? That's what I mean by your sales and marketing skills. We have to be really good at this in order to make things move smoother. Use effective questions to solicit input from those who will be affected by the change, and we'll talk about this in a little bit. You want to ask good open questions so you can garner their information as you're ready to plot and plan, with their help, a change plan. Skilled change leaders, this is how we set ourselves apart. We need to be comfortable with facilitating a wide range of group interaction. And when I talk about that, I mean, maybe you're going to have little focus groups in your meeting room. Maybe you're going to come in on different shifts and have little group talks, kind of casual. Maybe on the weekend you'll have some group interactions. You have to be comfortable with one-on-one, small groups, different education levels, and as well as if you had to have a discussion or group talk with your radiologist. So we have to be very comfortable with this. This is part of our jobs. Okay? And if not, just act. Pretend. If you talk yourself into it, you can do it, and you will come off as a good facilitator. It takes practice. Okay? Use impromptu brainstorming. Like teaching and facilitating a class, you know, get your flip charts out and your whiteboard. I mean, use all the tools, because people learn and get involved as you write for them and they start spawning off ideas. Kind of like a marketing ad campaign that you're planning. That's kind of the context in the environment that you try and set up. Okay? Use well-structured problem-solving sessions. And when I say that, I mean you have to have a little plan before you get these people together, right? You're not just going to go in there and say, ooh, let's just see kind of what happens. You have to, you're crazy. God bless you if you do that. You're a brave soul. But you have to have kind of a little plan to make it successful. And to have, you know your people, you know your culture and your organization. So pretend, I always try to put myself in their shoes and try and think, how would I want someone to involve me and to bring me into something? And that's how I plan and design something before I'm getting ready to do my focus groups or my, my little discussion so we can get information together. If you do that, you're 80% done. If you always plan and design with, how would I want someone to ask me to help with the change?